Russia is making significant strides in developing its next-generation fighter, with reports emerging that the country is reviving the Yakovlev Yak-141 vertical takeoff and landing, or VTOL, jet concept. The move is part of a broader Russian effort to create a 6th-generation fighter, potentially equipped with advanced stealth capabilities, hypersonic speeds, and next-generation avionics. The revival of the Yak-141, a Soviet-era VTOL aircraft, suggests that Moscow is considering incorporating vertical takeoff and landing capabilities into its future fighter jets, possibly to increase the operational flexibility of the Russian Navy and Air Force. Originally developed in the 1980s, the Yak-141 was a remarkable VTOL fighter designed for aircraft carriers. The aircraft featured a three-engine configuration with a powerful lift system allowing it to take off vertically. However, despite its advanced technology, the Yak-141 was never mass-produced due to the Soviet Union's collapse and financial constraints in the 1990s. Interestingly, the Yak-141's technology later influenced the development of the Lockheed Martin F-35B, the world's only operational VTOL stealth fighter today. Some experts believe that Russia's new VTOL fighter might be a direct response to the F-35B and its increasing presence in Western military forces. With the Russian Navy planning to modernize its Admiral Kuznetsov aircraft carrier and explore future carrier designs, the need for a next-gen VTOL fighter has grown. Traditional catapult-assisted takeoff aircraft require larger carriers, whereas VTOL jets can operate from smaller vessels, making them an ideal choice for a future Russian carrier strike group. Some analysts speculate that Russia's upcoming 6th-generation VTOL fighter jet will be designed with several new features. The first is stealth technology similar to the Su-57 and Su-75 Checkmate. The second, supercruise capability for high-speed operations. The third is AI-assisted avionics to increase situational awareness. The fourth is hypersonic weapon compatibility. And fifth, an energy-based weapon system for future combat scenarios. While reviving the Yak-141 concept may seem promising, Russia will face several challenges. The first challenge is technological and financial constraints. Developing a modern VTOL fighter is complex and requires a large investment. The second challenge is the problem of engine development. Powerful and efficient lift engines are essential for a viable VTOL fighter, and Russia has struggled with engine technology in recent years. The third challenge is sanctions and material shortages. Western sanctions have limited Russia's access to high-tech components, affecting its aerospace industry. And the fourth challenge is Navy limitations. Russia currently lacks a modern aircraft carrier fleet capable of fully utilizing a VTOL fighter. Despite these challenges, Russia's aerospace industry has a history of resilience. If a new VTOL fighter is successfully developed, it could significantly boost Russia's naval and air power, countering Western dominance in next-generation fighter technology. Reviving the Yak-141's VTOL design for a 6th-generation fighter is a bold move by Russia, potentially reshaping future air and naval combat. However, the success of this program depends on overcoming technological, economic, and geopolitical obstacles. If Russia manages to push forward with this project, the world could see a new era of VTOL stealth fighters, challenging the dominance of Western aircraft like the F-35B. What do you think? Could Russia's new VTOL fighter change the balance of power in modern warfare?